before I start this Flat Earth mini documentary, according to the Brainwashed, I have to state that you may download this video and put it into your own YouTube channel, and you may monetize it. According to the Brainwashed. Whether you like it or not, you are brainwashed. If you believe in the globe Earth, you are brainwashed. I can walk right now into any state school, go into a geography class, or even these days a science class, or possibly even a math class, and I will see the globe. This is brainwashing. This is your indoctrination. That's why I'm saying that if you believe the Earth is a globe, then do not turn off yet, because you have been brainwashed all your life into believing it, and you haven't even second-guessed it or asked any questions about it, about if it's the truth. And when I say you believe it, you do not believe the Earth is a globe. You get given the globe Earth, and you are told to believe it. You do not get given choices. You are told to believe it. This is a great example of brainwashing. You should always be questioning every single thing you get given to you in life. Why? And that's what I did about the globe. After learning it for several years. I am coming on 15 this year, and I questioned the globe a year ago. And it took me a while to believe in the Flat Earth. I was always balancing across the globe Earth to the Flat Earth. But once you do some deep research, you realise the truth. At the very start, you do not want to believe that the Earth is flat. You do not want to believe that you've been lied to all your life. This is called cognitive dissonance. It's what you all have right now if you're a globe earther. Cognitive dissonance. I can say I've been a solid flat earther for 5 months. I've had this YouTube channel for 3.5 months. I am not brainwashed about the Earth. We are all still learning. But learning about the globe Earth isn't learning. It's indoctrination. Because it isn't true, okay guys? The globe Earth does not exist. It has always been flat, and it remains flat to this day. If you're a Christian, and in my church, I go to my church, and they have the globe. I bring up the subject of a flat Earth after 3 weeks of me going, and I state, this is what they said. It is a misunderstanding in translations that Isaiah, in Isaiah 40:22, said he sits above the circle, referring to the circle as the earth. Now, for globe earthers, if you wish to call them that, they may not know the actual map of the flat earth. It isn't the Mercator projection, what we regularly see as a flat earth on a map. In fact, currently the flat earth community uses the AE map. Look it up on Wikipedia if you must. It's the globe squashed down into a circle. Currently, the Flat Earth community is trying to make a Flat Earth map, though, so can I just say that? Back onto the point, though. Because they said that, my church said it's a misunderstanding in translations, and that it's actually a sphere whizzing around infinite space, I left my church. Not my whole religion, I just left the church that I went to, okay? That's how passionate I am about this. I'm not an attention-seeker fool, like some of you might say, or an idiot. I am well-educated, not indoctrinated. I question everything, and that's what you should be doing. So, this documentary is called According to the Brainwashed, or mini-documentary. According to the Brainwashed, because of these necklines. So, according to the Brainwashed, the Earth is a sphere. According to the Brainwashed, water can go over curves. According to the Brainwashed, we are now flying through space. According to the Brainwashed, the Earth is spinning. According to the Brainwashed, aliens may exist. According to the Brainwashed, God is not real. And according to the Brainwashed, the Big Bang happened. Okay? Now, before any of you jump to conclusion, if you're not a Christian, whilst the Flat Earth may be a very religious theory, which is also a very logical theory, and for people who choose science rather than religion, which is actually a very poor choice to make out of the two, science, by definition, is classed as observation. Not a prediction. Observation, okay? Do you know what I observe on a regular basis? A flat horizon. Although, you walk in, again, you walk into any state school, and in science lessons, they thoroughly teach the fact that the Earth is curved. From where I am seeing, I see no curvature. I see a flat horizon. You go out onto the sea, or in fact in any landmass that does not have anything in the way, that's why the sea is the best, because it has no obstacles. I see a flat horizon. That's, by definition, is science proving the flat Earth. So technically, science mixes very well into religion. Because in the ancient civilizations, the church taught that the Earth is indeed flat. They taught that the Earth is flat, and that's the fact. Because it is the fact. Once you research it thoroughly, can I just say, you realize that you have been lied to. You have been brainwashed. So, science and religion can very well be mixed together. Just modern day science cannot be mixed together at all with religion. Modern day science is not science. Can I just get that straight? Because modern day science, as I said before, you can go straight into a state school, go into a science classroom, and they're learning about atoms. And now, as much as I'm crazy for thinking this, or maybe even coming up with this theory, I do not see atoms. That is not observation. As well as atoms may exist, it's not science. I do not see the atom. It is not observation. I cannot see it. Observation is when you can see something and interpret it. I do not see it and I do not interpret it. They may well be there, like I said. But it's not science, whether you like it or not, by definition, according to the Oxford Dictionary. Go and look it up yourself if you wish. If you have to. If you do not trust me, look it up. Now, going back onto the point of the flat earth, okay? Ancient civilization, let's just start going back in time with the flat earth. Ancient civilizations knew that the Earth was flat. until people like Aristotle and Pythagoras came along and said otherwise. Why? Pythagoras thought that the earth was a sphere because he planted two sticks in the ground at different locations, thousands of miles away, waited for 4 hours, and then saw something. He apparently saw that the shade on the sticks planted into the ground have changed. There is many incorrections about this, many false scriptures about Pythagoras. Yes, he may thought that the earth was a sphere. But this observation is obviously a lie. Well, observation, I say. It's not even an observation. Because firstly, you can't plant other sticks in the ground thousands of miles across. This is going back, I think it was the 1700s. You can't even plant sticks thousands of miles away, drive 4 hours, and still get to that other stick whilst recording it. So that's his theory debunked just like that, whilst Aristotle looked up to the moon, and Aristotle said that, and I quote, the moon's shape, well, the shade on the moon is curved. Yes, you look up to the moon and you can see where the shaded bit is, and it's curved. Well, firstly, a thing to know about the flat Earth model is that the moon, well, can I just say, just say a minute, that meant that most flat earthers do believe this, not all, but the moon is producing its own light, and that's from the Bible. So again, if you're Christian, the Bible says the moon is producing its own light, okay? Now, obviously, it's not. It's a different light from the sun. It's a second light. I'm quoting the Bible. It's a second light. I can't remember the page or whatever, but it's a second light from the sun. And it's a different kind of light from the sun. A light to light up the night. That is quoting the Bible. So, actually, yes, it would be much darker without the moon. And much colder as well. The moon gets its own source of energy and it has phases. Okay? That's why we see a shade, because that side of that part of the moon is not lit up. The moon and the sun orbit around the top of the earth. The moon obviously orbits around the top of the earth between 28 and 31 days, whilst the sun orbits around the top of the earth at 24 hours. Takes full orbit, it takes 24 hours. Now the sun and the moon, according to modern day science, which is not science at all, as I've said, actually say that, oh, the sun's 93 million miles away. It's millions of miles in circumference. And the moon is 280,000 kilometers away. And I don't know what they're saying, but the size, it's a third of the size of the Earth. And actually, the math, and they say that the math works out so that eclipses happen because the sun and the sun and the moon look the same size to us, because the sun is 400 times larger than it is, the sun is 400 times further away. That isn't the case. Apparently it's a coincidence. Well, I do not believe in coincidences, okay? Can I just make that clear? And if you're a Christian, you should not believe in coincidences. You should believe that God makes things for a reason. And even if you do not believe in any religion whatsoever, coincidences cannot happen, okay? Well, they may happen if you want to. But coincidences do not happen. It would happen by math, coincidences. Can happen by math, but that's not a coincidence, because that's something happening for a reason. But anyway, getting back to the point, it's because the sun and the moon are actually the same size. Modern flat earth estimates, the sun and the moon to be 30 to 32 miles in circumference and actually around 3,200 miles high. Now, whether you, as a flat earther, you believe that the moon and the sun are that big and that further slash close away, is off the fact. Fact is that they are closer than you think, they are smaller than you think. Now, to sum off the flat earth model, why do you think the first ever spaceship that NASA sends into space catches fire, explodes, burns, whatever you want to call it, explodes, okay? It does not reach outer space. And it's simply because there is no outer space. Space does not exist. There is a dome or a firmament in the way. And going back to the flat earth map with the AE map, Antarctica is around the edge. Now that dome goes to Antarctica. Now, this is actually quite a debatable topic in the flat earth community at the moment, whether there is a dome or not. The majority of flat earthers believe there is a dome. The evidence for a dome is supported by two facts. One from the Bible again. It mentions a dome, firmament, in the creation story in Genesis. And also, in fact, Antarctica is sealed off by the UN. You step on Antarctica, the government, the UN, signed by, I think, the Antarctic Treaty, this is, signed by 58 nations, including North Korea, they will shoot you. You are not allowed on Antarctica without permission. Yes, you may see documentaries on TV going to Antarctica, the BBC, ABC, but that is a government agency, guys. They're allowed on Antarctica because they are the government. You've got to remember, the government must control all. Yes. Obviously, I'm being sarcastic. I do not believe that. But that's what's happening at the moment. The UN controls all. Now, the UN flag is the flat earth map. Now, what I want you to do is go and open a new tab, if you want to, and type in UN flag, and it's clearly the flat earth map. Why in the world would the UN flag, the global government, global government, be a flat earth map? Because the earth is flat, and they want you to look stupid. They want to laugh at you. There's officials at the UN who will be sleeping. Well, when they are falling asleep, they will be laughing directly at you. They will be saying this. These stupid people. Our map shows the AE flat earth map. Yet, they look at our map and they do not think of the flat earth. They still think the earth is a globe. We control everybody. We are the best. Illuminati and Freemasons are our best friends. I agree with the Matrix. That's what they'll be saying. Now, going back to Antarctica and the Antarctic Treaty is what it's called. Have you ever known any treaty in the world to have North Korea, Russia, the United States to be all signed onto one treaty and all be working together with one treaty? I do not know it. North Korea and the US and Russia, those three nations are the worst enemies ever. And yet, it is the only treaty when those three nations sign a treaty together. They are working together on this. And as you know, North Korea really do hate the US. Another way round, Russia hates the US, US hates Russia, US hates North Korea. Any Western world country hates Russia, any Western world country hates North Korea. I have never known. And there is no treaty where they are working together to protect Antarctica. This is apparently the Antarctic Treaty for non-violent research into Antarctica and to apparently save the Earth from global warming. Now, firstly, this is a lie. We know this, because if you step on Antarctica right now, they say, we will shoot you. Does that sound non-violent to you? You go into the Antarctic Treaty, you cannot step a foot in Antarctica. They say, they will shoot you. Why? To planet Earth, it's just another place of Earth. To planet Earth, we've got another pole, the North Pole, which actually in the flat Earth map is the middle. Why is Antarctica so special? On a planet. Well, on a flat Earth, the AE map, it is the edge of the world before you hit the dome. That's why the government don't want you to know, because they will shoot you. They do not want you to know. And then there's people like us, the flat earthers, who are risking our lives, getting... Sometimes we are getting stalked by the CIA, SIS, whatever you want to call them, MI6, MI5, for your freedom. To know the truth. And you spit it back in our faces. I'm just saying this because I know that any flat earther who has a YouTube channel, because any flat earther who has a YouTube channel has gone to a great extent and believes almost 100% that the earth is flat. I know no flat earther can believe 99%. There's always there is always that bit of doubt. Those bad days where you think, life is so bad. What about if I'm wrong because life is so bad? There are those days. But if you get to the point where you make a flat earth YouTube channel, then you know the earth is flat. There are not people out there making flat earth videos for attention. There are people making flat earth videos out there because there's overwhelming evidence to support the fact that the earth is flat. Okay, getting on to the next fact. According to the Brainwashed, the earth is curved. Now, you see boats going over the horizon. This is arguably the most globe earth fact you can think of. That the bottom of the ship goes over the... You cannot see the bottom of the ship first because it goes over the curvature. This is a lie, I'm afraid. It can easily be explained. Firstly, I want to say, if the boat has gone over the curvature, supposed curvature of the Earth, why in the world can you not see the curve? If you go on the boat in the middle of the ocean, and you've got 360 degrees to look round, 360 degrees, there is no curve. Now apparently the boat goes over the horizon, and you cannot see the bottom, and then you cannot see the whole boat because of the curve. This is not true, is it? Now, because you would see the curve, obviously, if you looked, people have said to me, if you look straight, directly forward, you may not see the curve because it's gone over, but if you look to your right, you should see some points of curvature. It's slightly curving. You should be able to see every centimetre of curvature, yet you see none. There was a great documentary about this, she left when she was 14, but I think she was 16, Europe girl, travelling around the world, and they show some great clips of her in a boat, and it does not seem like she is sensing any curvature whatsoever when she is moving and shipping, if you wish to call it that, whatever you want to call it, round the earth. Okay? None whatsoever. Tell me why you can't... People, us Flat Earth community, in the Flat Earth community, have done this. We have bought lasers, like, lasers that are worth a lot of money, high quality lasers, with red dots. We point them out into the sea. There's somebody on the sea in a boat, and where they shouldn't see the laser coming at them, they still see the laser. And they can't see the person, but they can still see the laser. Now, this is because the laser doesn't have to travel around any of the curvature. But obviously, the explanation for this is the vanishing point. It's called the vanishing point, okay? Convergence, whatever you want to call it. Convergence, vanishing point, is the horizon. You go and get a ruler right now. 20 centimeters, 30 centimeters, a meter ruler, You look down it, you place your eye on top of it, you look down it, one meter, whatever, however long it is, down to the bottom, and you would see it looks smaller down the end. That's called convergence. Vanishing point, whatever you want to call it. That's just a meter. You see how small it's got? That's just a meter. Now imagine those rulers laid out on a 360 degrees angle almost. 360 degrees around. And you put the meters into miles, 10 miles, whatever you want to, 5 miles. And it gets to a certain distance and it becomes too small to see the end of it. Or if you place a certain object on the end, it will come to a certain distance. If your ruler is miles long, it will get to a certain place where you will not be able to see that object on the end. That is convergence. That is how it works on the horizon. And the reason that the bottom of the ship goes away first is that it's just a fact on convergence that parts closer to the point of convergence will not be able to see first because it's closer to convergence. Now, the points above convergence will be able to see more. That's why the sun, you watch it go down. The sun's moving, remember? You watch it go down. And it gets to a certain, because it's orbiting a certain place, just say you're in the US, the other side of the world is Australia, you will not be able to see it as day. That's because it's got to a certain distance where it's gone past your convergence. Now, obviously, it's had to wait to Australia to get there, where if you sailed a boat to Australia, you wouldn't just be able to see America gone by. But that's because the sun is obviously bigger than any boat. We've stated before that the sun is about 30 miles large, 30 miles in circumference, sorry, and thousands of miles high. Not millions, thousands of miles high. Whilst a boat is directly on the sea, the place of convergence, and it depends how large your boat is, but it isn't miles, tens of miles wide. Okay? That's how it works. That's how convergence works. The next point of the brain, that the brainwashed say, according to the brainwashed, is that the Earth is flying around the sun now. Once I talked to people at the Flat Earth, people at my school, once they know I'm a Flat Earth, and they said, oh, you're fucking stupid, and stuff like that. Oh, but we've got pictures. Oh, fuck off, you're doing it for attention. Once we've got past that point, and people know, and after a few weeks, they do ask, well, the Flat Earth model, we must be just, well, they say, aren't we just flying through space then? No, that's what the Globe Earth model says. I'm like, really? That's what the Globe Earth model says. We are flying through space around the sun. That's part of billions of other suns in our galaxy. That's part of billions of other galaxies in our universe. And our universe is apparently part of parallel universes. It could not get more ludicrous. Seriously, it is absolute ludicrousy. Right. So apparently, the Earth is orbiting a sun. Apparently our sun's just normal, and that's why it looks from the sky a bit yellowish, you know. It looks not too big. It's just a normal sun. An average sun in our galaxy. And yet, when NASA take apparently photographs, which I will get to on next, apparently photographs of the sun, it looks completely different. We get this massive fireball that's spitting out fire that looks deep, deep orange. We do not observe that from the Earth. Again, that is science proving that the Earth, that the sun is actually quite small, quite timid, and quite yellow, which when us flat earthers in the flat earth community send space balloons up into the stratosphere, I don't know, 35 kilometers high, 37 kilometers high, we observe the sun as it is on Earth. We also observe no curvature. But again, because we've observed that and interpreted it, that's science suggesting that the flat earth model is in fact correct. Okay? whether you like it or not, that is science. And apparently you cannot argue with science. So apparently, let's get back to the point here. The Earth is flying around the Sun. The Sun is also moving, according to the brainwash. Which we do not observe that. We do not observe... Well, can I just say? I mean the Sun moving like a vortex, and the planets orbiting it whilst we're moving, and moons orbiting planets, but we'll get onto the gravitational pull of the moon in a minute, and apparently gravity in a minute. Yes, we do not observe our Earth moving. Our Earth moving around the Sun and then the Sun moving. Yes, we observe the Sun moving and orbiting actually the top of the Earth. But all these photographs of the Earth and the Sun in space show that the Earth and the Sun, in fact, are in line. The Sun is not higher in the solar system. In fact, they're nearly in line. And yet, we send space balloons with non-fisheye lens cameras that do not distort the image up into the stratosphere, and the Sun is high up into the sky. It is not in line with it. The Earth is not moving. In fact, the Earth is stationary. Yes, and the Sun produces a hot spot. Okay? Now, a hotspot, you may see it, I don't know if you've watched space balloon videos with that have normal cameras and not GoPros that distort images, but which they use fisheye lenses. But the Sun produces something called a hotspot. Now, a hotspot shines on the Earth, and it's from the Sun's rays, it shines on the Earth, and that's where the Sun is above, okay? That's called a Sun hotspot. Hotspots cannot happen if the Sun is it cannot happen if the Sun's directly in line with the Earth, and it can definitely not happen if it's 93 million miles away. The Sun must be local for a hotspot to happen, for the Sun's rays to travel to the Earth and produce a hotspot. Now what I like to do, obviously we cannot do this, the flat earthers do not have the money or the whatever you want to call it to do this, the funds or productivity to do this, because our movement is growing and once it gets bigger, once we reach 300,000 subscribers, the major flat earth YouTube channels, instead of between 20 and 40,000 subscribers, we may be able to do this, we may be able to rely on fan funding. But get back to the point, I think that Sun hotspots, seeing as the Sun rays are travelling down, it's where the Sun is directly above. Sun hotspots are the size of the Sun. Okay? I observe that, I interpret that the Sun is actually producing its own almost reflection onto the Earth. And seeing as a reflection, it must be the same size. I interpret that. Therefore, if I interpret that's, and I observe it more of, and that's independent imagery. I observe a flat horizon, I observe a Sun hotspot, I observe almost like a reflection figure. That is science, once again, proving the flat earth model. According to the brainwash, there are billions and trillions times gazillions, whatever you want to call it, people are mental these days, of planets. And there are trillions of suns, and there are billions of galaxies, and there are infinite numbers of universes that go parallel universes. You could not get more crazy. You say flat earthers are crazy for believing that, yes, we are the only celestial object, excluding the sun and the moon, the only things that we observe and the stars. But yet, apparently modern day science, which is not science at all as we've said before, says otherwise. That is ludicrous to think that heliocentrism says that, in fact,
there are an infinite number of universes. In those universes are the same thing as yours, the same you, but just with different... Just if you left your house a minute later today, another parallel universe was created, and it's the same for everybody! All major events in your life. I don't know, if you won the lottery here, because you bought a car, you bought a ticket on a certain day, a certain time, a certain second, in a certain shop, you won the lottery. Whilst in another parallel universe, you didn't win the lottery because you were another 10 minutes later. It's ludicrous to think that. Absolutely ludicrous. You cannot get more crazy than that. And apparently we're crazy because we observe one object that we are standing on. We observe the sun and the moon to be the same size. And we observe stars not to be planets. Right, let's get on to stars before I get on to gravity. Stars are very... It's a massive argument, debate, between flat earthers in the flat earth community. Some flat earthers think that stars are simply just... nothing, they're just lights in the sky. Some people think they're cracks in the firmament. Some people think that they're dead angels, or some people think that they're frequencies of heaven. Doesn't matter what I think, because there's no research on stars yet in the flat earth community. That's one thing that does need researching, actually, is stars. But yeah, there is research on stars, yes, that we observe and we interpret. Us flat earth community, we've got together, we funded money to buy thousands of pounds worth of camera equipment just for this simple activity. What we've done is we've zoomed in with massive lenses, top class filming lenses. We've zoomed into Mars. It looks absolutely nothing like NASA show us. Firstly, we just observe a brownish dot in the sky. Yet NASA showed us this red planet with polar ice caps, with mountains, with valleys. Oh yeah. No. Let's get back down to reality here. I'm observing that Mars is just a little dot and it is not a planet. And in fact, what NASA show us are lies. Because if you type in Mars onto Google Images, you'll show pictures that vary. Okay? CGI, even NASA admits it, it's CGI, that does vary. You get one time a brown planet, you get a red planet, one time you get no polar ice caps, one time you do get ice caps, one time it doesn't look like there's any mountains, sometimes you do, sometimes, face of something, whatever, on the face of a human face on Mars, oh yeah. And then what NASA do is they rank up the activity of the globular system by saying, maybe water on Mars. We do not observe water on Mars, okay? We zoom in with our camera, and we do not observe anything NASA tells us. Only that we do observe is a red little dot, brownish little dot in the sky. And because we observe that and we interpret it correctly as we see it, that again is science proving the flat earth model. And I suggest, if you just like what I'm saying about science, that actually, you do go to like a science authority saying, we need to change the topic. Oh, the topic name. Modern day science is not science. This teenager has proved it by simply showing us the definition of science. Because the definition of science has been like this since ancient centuries is observation. And many things in modern day science are not observation. We must change this now.
before more people find out. That's what they'll be saying. They can't change it because there'll be too much controversy. But that it should be changed. I don't know. Modern science should be called Satanism. But it should be changed, whether you like it or not. But getting back onto the point of stars, though, not trying to lose my way. This is meant to be a mini documentary. It's going a bit long. I'm trying to explain everything in my head, but still, I'm keeping to those sentences according to the Brainwashed, which is the name. So according to the Brainwashed, there are planets. As you just said about Mars, it's the same like any other planet. We zoom into it, we do not see what NASA show us. And we zoom into the suns that are apparently stars, and apparently all stars are the same size because most of them are suns and they're all the same distance away and whatnot, and planets aren't bigger suns, but mathematically they're the same. You know, there's so many coincidences in our apparent modern day science, what we like to call model, whatever. There's so many coincidences that really just do not match up. Do not match up whatsoever. Right, moving on to gravity. Yes, it's true that gravity dictates that a flat earth cannot be real. That's because gravity does not exist. It's a magical force. If you believe in gravity, you believe in magic. You know, we're currently in apparent science lessons, what should I say, Satanism lessons, in physics, we learn about gravity. I hate it. Why is it? I do hate the lessons in school in general, but I hate the fact that gravity is in science. Science is not this, okay? As I've said before in this, science is observation. I do not see gravity. People will be saying, yes, drop a pen onto the blimmin' floor. That's gravity. I do not see a magical hand coming up and pulling it down. Or a yellow, orangey, whatever colour you want it to be, force dragging it down to the floor at 9.8... I don't even know, seconds per whatever. I don't give a shit. It does not exist. I do not see it. It's not a science. It's not observation. In fact, it can be explained for something much more logical, which we do observe. We observe an object's size and its density. You drop it, yes, it will fall. But a gas like helium, just say helium for a minute. You take a helium balloon, you obviously fill it up with helium, and you know from when you had kids' birthday parties, or if you have kids and you take them to birthday parties, or you remember when you were a kid and you went to other people's birthday parties or had your own birthday parties, you had helium balloons to take back in little gift bags. I don't know if you do that over in the US. I've never been to the US. We do it over in the UK a lot, gift bags, etc. And once about 2 minutes, once you've got home, people like to play football with it in their living room, whatnot. And then they like to take it in their car and whatnot. When you're younger, you like to keep it. But it will become a certain point when you're younger where you accidentally let go of it and you've had it. Because actually everything has a mass, okay? We can see that actually. That everything has a mass. The air has a mass. And so does helium. Helium has a mass. Now, fair enough, yes, this is what science teaches us, but this is also fact. Because we can smell helium, we can smell hydrogen, compared to the air. Now, the air has a mass. Now, if the mass, if that object, going back to the helium balloon, because it's very light, remember, helium is very light, the mass of the helium balloon is lighter than the mass of the air, therefore it will go up. Whereas if you have a pen, because obviously a pen has a greater mass and density than the air, it will drop. Okay? That is an explanation for gravity. Because we see it, we observe it. We observe a mass. We do not observe a magical force pulling us down to the ground if gravity existed. So just because I'm sitting there right now in a chair, recording this as I speak, apparently gravity is keeping my legs onto the chair, which is supporting the rest of my body. If gravity was so strong, and it attracts stuff to the surface of the earth, as I'm waving my hands about so enthusiastically whilst I'm speaking, why isn't constantly my arms trying to be dragged down to the floor? Do you know what I mean? When you kneel down on your carpet or wherever you are right now, why isn't your head constantly being banged to the floor and your back and your torso and whatnot? Why isn't everything trying to be if cushions are on your sofa? Because it's not hitting the surface, why aren't they trying to be constantly being hit on the sofa to try to... it's hysterical, isn't it? It's because that's what would happen with gravity. It's trying to attract stuff to it, the surface of the earth, apparently. But we do not observe that. We observe a mass, and once that mass is on stable ground, and can support that ground, it does no longer fall because it's got support. And if there are no objects in the way and you release a mass, this could be as easy as a pen releasing it onto the floor. Then it hits the surface of the earth because that's the closest object in the way for it to stop it keep falling. Okay? Gravity does not exist. It's magic, gravity. And we all know magic doesn't exist if you're under the age of 10. Because tell me, if gravity did exist, then gravitational waves, I've been a lot in the media in February, which I did a video on, but getting back to the point, gravitational waves, if they existed. So apparently, according to the Brainwashed, the Earth is orbiting the Moon. Yes? And apparently, the Moon has a gravitational pull on the Earth, which affects the waves on the Earth. So that means the Moon has its own sense of gravity, gravitational pull on it. Why isn't there little bits of rock? Why isn't there a mini-moon orbiting the Moon? And then a mini-mini-moon orbiting the Moon? And a mini-mini-mini-moon orbiting that mini-mini-moon? And a mini-mini-mini, and a mini-mini-mini-moon orbiting that mini-mini-moon? And a mini-mini-mini-mini-moon orbiting that mini-mini-mini-moon? Till you get to a bit of rock being orbited by a bit of... a rock the same size of a granule of sand. Why do you not get that? We do not see that. Now, I'm going to make my last bit of conversation almost. I didn't want this to be too formal. Before I call it an end, because it is meant to be a mini documentary, but there you go. Hoping to get this under an hour. Going on to it, there are no photographs of Earth. No photographs of Earth, guys. This is what the Brainwashed, according to the Brainwashed. Oh yes, the Earth is not flat because we get pictures. They do say, can I just say, I'm obviously coming on to 15 and I'm at school. And they do say pictures of the other. I lose everybody here. I hate people my own age. I'm sorry, but I hate people my own age. And they say, yes, but we've got pictures of the Earth. And I say, yes, pictures, exactly pictures. They're like, What? Of course, some people do say photos and photographs of the Earth. People do say pictures, that's the problem. It's pictures, it's CGI. NASA even admits it on their website. They quote it's CGI. There's only two officially confirmed photographs of the Earth with no other celestial objects in its way. And yet, you buy, or you can download the free version of Adobe Photoshop, and you expose the image's brightness, and you can see a massive square pixel around where Earth is. That really does show that it was put there by editing. Well, not by editing, by making the photo, by creating the photo, by CGI. And also, NASA do say, and I have to admit on the CGI, that they get the data from satellites. I don't see satellites. Even in NASA's photos that they take, I follow on Twitter just to try to debunk, theoretically, in my head, photographs of the International Space Station. I try to, I follow them, I follow Tim Peake and Scott Kelly, the Freemasons, on Twitter, and they daily, once a day, they post a photograph of Earth. And apparently there's 13,000 satellites currently orbiting our Earth. You do not see any else. Okay? When the International Space Station was first created by whatever governments now own it, whatever space agencies now own it, whatever, they put it up there, they take a few photographs, you know, because social media wasn't really around then. They show almost a blue marble, blue sea, which what we expect it to be. I'm not saying it's right, but it's how you expect it to be, but NASA has lost its way now. You see the Northern Lights all the time. All you see is the Northern Lights. Yeah? Apparently the Northern Lights happen every night. They come across the UK. That's what they're showing on these Twitter things. Where back when the International Space Station was created, we did not get those photos. We got the sea, we got no Northern Lights. NASA is always inconsistent. That's what's wrong with them. Inconsistency. They are not inconsistent. Moving on to the ISS. I didn't learn this fact until a fellow Flat Earth YouTube channel made a video about the International Space Station, the ISS. World's governments have spent $150 billion on the International Space Station since it was created. The biggest waste of money in the world is that you could eradicate world poverty in every single nation if they did not spend money on the International Space Station. And can I just say, by eradicating poverty? That's brainwashing more people. That's more people in so-called education. Indoctrination, brainwashing. That's more people believing in the globe. So why don't they do that? Yet, we have $150 billion ISS space station up in apparently orbit right now. It's the biggest waste of money on Earth. They would not do it. Right, just say it is fake because it is fake, okay? we've debunked this. It is fake. That's the first thing. It is fake. Just say they spent, at tops, this is coming right off my head now, $1 billion over the years in wages to everybody who has had some involvement in it, wages to all the actors that are apparently on it, but actually in some underground bunker, all the crap they have to make, the apparent photographs of Earth from the International Space Station. Let's just say over the years, at worst, $1 billion. That's $149 billion left over. That's $149 billion in their back pockets. $149 billion to the global elites and the politicians, the higher politicians of this world. And can I just say, if you're a globe earther, everything made and everything stated in this mini documentary isn't just some rubbish, okay? As I say, you'll have cognitive dissonance, okay? You're not believing it. You may think I'm crazy. I don't care, to be quite frank. I care about the truth. And I die for the rest of humanity. For the rest of humanity to know the truth about our real world. And I'm stating everything as fact to you guys. The brainwashing will get in your way, but hand on heart, everything that I say is facts. Coming on to why they lie, and the secret society to sort of hopefully try to round up and pull up this mini documentary to the end. There's two main reasons why they lie. They live, we sleep, while flat earthers are awake. But we do not live. They lie, this coincides with every single secret society, every single global elite, every single politician, NASA, ESA, whatever. All these authorities, they lie about the Earth for two major reasons. Number one is money. Okay? Money, 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 money! It's what keeps the global elites and the secret societies running. It's money. As you said before, just by the ISS hoax, International Space Station hoax, they've gained $149 billion. And as we all know, in this current world that we live in, the matrix that we live in, the matrix society that we live in, money equals power. So $149 billion is a lot of power. Directly onto my second reason. It's power. They want power over you. The global elites and politicians that run the secret societies, like the Rothschild families that are in charge of every central bank of every nation in this world, apart from North Korea, apart from Cuba, and apart from Iran. It's the family like them who are worth the most in the world that are part of these secret societies. Secret societies, Freemasons, Illuminatis, whatever you want to call them. They're all the same. They may be... We don't know enough about this yet because we're just asleep. we're just the public. They may all be the same societies. They may be different. There may be different societies but with the same people that have different so-called objectives for the world. They all know the same thing. The Earth is flat. God is real. They shove it in our faces in media, okay? There was a 1963 series in the US, I can't remember what it's called. If you look up Naomi 1963 on YouTube, it will bring you to a video where it's a 1963 series, I can't remember what it's called, but it's the introduction of the series. In every episode, it has the US national anthem with the subtitles in bold, covering almost half the screen. And actually, ODDTV has done a video on this, and it's an absolute great video, Overdose Denver. That's what it stands for. It's a great video on it. If you slow it down, you watch the subtitles roll past, and actually says, you've been lied to. You can see it as the national anthem subtitles are coming up. Once they're rolling over, you can slow it down. You've got to slow it down quite quickly, though. Slow it down, but it's very slow. It will say, God is real, God is watching. You have been lied to. Money is power. You are just slaves. That's what it will say, guys. It's not a lie. Type in ODDTV, and that's what it will say. On his video. I'm not lying. They're the ones lying. And that's how I want to round up. You are the brainwashed. You are the ones who are asleep. In this mini documentary, we have gone through all the according to the brainwash statements and debunked them. I hope this is a very good Flat Earth mini documentary. My channel is called The Flat Earth Movement. If you'd click subscribe and share this video for it to become a viral video, I'd very much appreciate that. Whilst at the same time opening a new tab and going into your browser and typing gofundme.com/flat earth studio. The writing that's been on the bottom right of your screen all this time, gofundme.com/flat earth studio. And that is a link to take you to GoFundMe. It's a GoFundMe page to keep my YouTube channel running and to professionalise the Flat Earth movement in general. I hope you have much liked this mini documentary. I hope it comes very high in the Flat Earth videos list, because everything that I've stated is true. Okay? The Earth is flat. Just think, how would you feel if you wake up tomorrow and on your TV screens, on the media, it said NASA releases the Earth is flat? They won't, but how would you feel if they said that?